Alright, so let's do another gender bender review. This time it's the movie Carla. Carl, apostrophe XIII, which was made in 2011. It's an indie movie. I'm pretty sure that I actually pledged for this movie when it was on, you know, GoFundMe or something like that, fundraiser. And it was released a few years later, in 2014. And it actually stars actual transsexuals for once. So it stars the Laverne Cox from Orange is the New Black and Jocelyn Fries as the main character, Carla. So anyway, Carla is a transsexual, and as a common stereotype and trope when it comes to transsexuals, she works sexually, she is a cam girl. And she makes money from that, and her best friend, Cinnamon, who's played by Laverne Cox, is a prostitute. Yeah, we have a problem already here, but let's not think too much about that for now. Anyway, she runs into this extremely clingy guy who's been following her online for like a year, and yeah, he's a nerdy stalker, and she agrees to meet him, and after having a, you know, unsuccessful meeting with her family, because neither her parents nor her brother support Carla for being trans, her grandfather does, or he says that it's hard, but that he's accepting of her and so, and he tries, you know, to arrange a meeting, but it just goes to shit. Anyway, Carla meets Sam, or whatever his name was. Sam it was, yes. And yeah, they start hanging out more and more. He gets beaten up when he's meekly trying to defend her. He really doesn't really try to defend her. And this Carla sees like, wow, such a hot guy. And yeah, then their relationship just progresses. Her grandfather tries to fix her up with her mom again, but it just doesn't work. And then her grandfather dies, and he leaves her like $400,000. And yeah, Carla wants to spend it on surgery, but Sam is not interested in Carla having surgery or sexual reassignment surgery. So he's against it. They break up, and she goes and has surgery. The end. Yeah. This movie, when I pledged for this once upon a time, I was hoping for much more than I got. I mean, I thought that this could, you know, delve a bit deeper into, you know, gender identity and transsexualism, especially when you have two transsexuals in the movie playing lead roles. But nope, you get the standard sex worker angle that is way, 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 way too common for movies about transsexuals or transgender women. There aren't that many about men. Of course, there is Buck Angel, but he works with sex in real life as a porn actor. So, would I recommend this movie? It's a decent watch, but as I said, it just succumbs to too many tropes and all that. But if you want to see a movie with transgender actors, it's definitely worth a watch. I would give it about a 5 out of 10 or so on the IMDb scale. It's clearly an indie movie, it's low budget. And the acting isn't that great from all the people either. Laverne Cox does a very well good job. Jocelyn as Carlin does a nice job, but at least when it comes to playing the transsexual part, but then the relationships and all that, it feels kind of stale, and it just seems to be very forced things here in this movie. And yeah, forced things are unnecessary if, because you can develop things better, and this movie could have been longer, and I think it would have benefited from that. It's only about, I think, like 80 minutes at max. Oh, it's 100 minutes. Yeah, but it did not feel that, like that, because there were many things that, you know, were rushed and didn't feel properly developed and so. So, that's pretty much it for this movie. So, bye-bye.